Hello
and welcome dear student in the next module of the topic solution. So in this topic we have completed the four qualitative properties as the vapor pressure lowering, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point and the osmotic pressure. So we are related with these four qualitative properties, and in this there is a relation between all the qualitative properties and the molar mass of the solute. So next to that, in the next lecture we have discussed about the Van't Hoff factor. Van't Hoff factor means what? How we define the Van't Hoff factor? Because the qualitative properties for the electrolytic solution, it get changed for the non-electrolytic solution. Means when we add the electrolyte to the solvent to form a solution, then the number of moles of solute particles are changed and henceforth the qualitative properties for the electrolytic solutions are also changed, and therefore that change from the non-electrolytic solution is given by the factor called as a Van't Hoff factor. It is called as a Van't Hoff factor, and it is defined as, the Van't Hoff factor is defined as, here it is the ratio of the qualitative properties of the solution of electrolytes divided by the qualitative properties of the non-electrolyte solution of the same concentration. Means the I here is defined as, I means the Van't Hoff factor, which is equal to qualitative property of the electrolytic solution to the qualitative property for the non-electrolytic solution. And the electrolytic solution, the qualitative property for the electrolytic solution is called as a Cp observed, and that for non-electrolyte it is called as a Cp theoretical. And therefore these are the qualitative properties of the electrolytic solution, and these are the qualitative property for the non-electrolytic solution. So here we have a relation that the qualitative property, here the qualitative property means Cp observed, which is equal to I into Cp theoretical. We have the relation between Cp observed and Cp theoretical as qualitative property observed, which is equal to I into Cp theoretical. So that part we have completed in our last lecture. So dear student, in this today's lecture we are going to study the Van't Hoff factor, that means the relation between Van't Hoff factor and the degree of dissociation. Then what is mean by this term, a degree of dissociation? In the 11th standard, in the topic chemical equilibrium, so in the topic chemical equilibrium here we have a concept of a degree of dissociation. As what is mean by degree of dissociation? A degree of dissociation is denoted by a letter alpha, and which is equal to alpha, which is equal to the number of moles of an electrolyte dissociated into the total number of moles. Manjes dilele je kai total number of moles ahe, tya moles madhun kiti moles dissociate hotat te, manjes kay mhanto apan, te manjes apan te kay mhanto hai, number of moles dissociated means the moles dissociated out of the total number of moles are called as alpha. Alpha means the degree of dissociation. Degree of dissociation manje ghetle kiti ani tyachyapaki dissociate jhale kiti, ti ji kai term ahe, it is called as a degree of dissociation. So for the relation between Van't Hoff factor and degree of dissociation, here we have to consider an electrolyte AXBY. This is our electrolyte and that dissociated into aqueous solution as. The AXBY means, for example here, instead of AXBY, if we have another electrolyte like NaCl, if we have a NaCl as electrolyte, then it dissociated into minus. It dissociated into Na plus and Cl minus. Just like the NaCl, here we have an electrolyte Ax and By and which dissociate partially because this arrow is reversible. Reversible means this dissociate partially into A plus and Y minus. Into A plus and Y minus. Suppose initially, here initially if we have taken a 1 mole of an electrolyte. Here we have taken a 1 mole of an electrolyte and therefore initially only the reactants are present. What is the concentration of the product? It is equal to 0,0. It is equal to 0,0. Therefore, but when the equilibrium is reached between these reactant and the product, then at equilibrium only here the alpha be the degree of dissociation. At equilibrium means initially we have taken the 1 mole of an electrolyte. Therefore, what is the initial mole of dissociated ion? Which is equal to 0,0. But at equilibrium, let alpha be the degree of dissociation of an electrolyte. Then the moles of cations and the anions dissociated are alpha and alpha. And why it is X alpha? Because the X mole of A and Y mole of B, it can be dissociated. It can be dissociated. And therefore, let alpha be the degree of dissociation. Alpha be the degree of dissociation. Therefore, how much amount of reactant it remains at equilibrium? Let initially the 1 mole of an electrolyte is present and let alpha be the degree of dissociation, then the number of moles remains undissociated at equilibrium for the reactant, which is equal to how many? It is equal to 1 minus alpha. It is equal to 1 minus alpha. That means the alpha number of moles, they get dissociated and therefore the 1 minus alpha moles remains undissociated at equilibrium. It remains undissociated at the equilibrium. And therefore the total number of moles after dissociation, how many total number of moles are remains? Which is equal to 1 minus alpha. This is the moles for the electrolyte AXBY and this is the mole of A plus and this is the number of moles of B minus. And therefore the total number of moles after dissociation, which is equal to the sum of these and this term. And if we simplify these, then we get the total number of moles after dissociation, which is equal to 1 plus alpha in bracket N minus 1. If we simplify this term, where here the X plus Y. If we simplify this term, if we take a common alpha from this term, then we get here 1 plus alpha in bracket X plus Y minus 1 in bracket. But here X plus Y are the total number of moles of an electrolyte which dissociated at equilibrium, where X plus Y, which is called as a N. Therefore, instead of X plus Y, here we have to put the N. Therefore, then the Vanta factor is given by I, which is equal to I means what? The actual moles of particles in solution after dissociation divided by moles of formula unit dissolved in a mole. That means here we have I, which is equal to N observed upon N theoretical from our formula. I, which is equal to N observed upon N theoretical, and therefore we have the observed number of moles for that electrolyte, which is equal to, in the last slide here we have seen here 1 plus alpha in bracket N minus 1. 1 plus alpha in bracket N minus 1. But theoretically, initially, how many number of moles here we have taken? here we have taken a 1 mole of an electrolyte, and therefore I, which is equal to here I, which is equal to 1 plus alpha n minus 1 divided by 1, means here I, which is equal to 1 plus alpha n minus 1, or alpha, which is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1. So you have to remember the relation between the Van 't Hoff factor and the degree of dissociation as here I, which is equal to I, which is equal to 1 plus alpha in bracket n minus 1, or alpha, which is equal to I minus 1 divided by n minus 1. So you have to remember this relation between I and alpha. So dear student, up to this, here we have completed our second topic, that is solution theoretically. इथपर्यंत आपण आपला दुसरा टॉपिक सोल्यूशन हा कंप्लीट केलेला आहे थेरॉटिकली. जस्ट वी हॅव डिस्कस सम एक्झाम्पल्स ऑन दिस टॉपिक हियर. सो हियर वी हॅव डिस्कस द एक्झाम्पल नंबर 9, द वेपर प्रेशर ऑफ अ वॉटर ऍट अ 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस इज 17 mmHg. What is the vapor pressure of a solution containing 2.8 gram urea in 50 gram of water? You have to solve all the examples which is given in your exercise. Here just we have discussed this example. Then this is the 9th number example. Then what is the given data? In this example here we have given, here we have given data, that means the vapor pressure of water. Water is a vapor pressure, means the vapor pressure of a solvent, and it is denoted by a letter P01, and which is equal to 17 mmHg, which is equal to 17 mmHg. Then what is the vapor pressure of a solution? That means the vapor pressure of a solution is denoted by a letter P1, which is equal to, we have to calculate that, then it containing 2.8 gram urea in 50 gram of water. Here we have given the weight of urea and the weight of water. Urea is a solute and water is a solvent, and therefore weight means the mass W1, 1 for solvent, and which is equal to 50 gram. What is the weight of a solute? Urea is used as a solute here, and W2, which is equal to weight of the solute, which is equal to 2.8 gram. Then this is our given data. Next, in the next step, this is the first step for solving any one of the numerical. In the second step, we have to write the formula used to calculate the vapor pressure of a solution. And we have a formula here, delta P divided by P01, which is equal to W2 M1 M2 W1. So this formula we have to use to calculate the vapor pressure of a solution. Then next, third step, we have to start solving the example. So formula, this is the formula used to calculate the vapor pressure of a solution. So here we have started for the solution, and here the solution, which is equal to, from the formula here, delta P upon P01, which is equal to P01 minus P1 divided by p not 1 and which is equal to here W2 M1 divided by M2 W1. So we have to calculate here we have to calculate the P1, that means the relative, from this relative lowering of vapor pressure, what is the delta P, which is equal to P01 minus P1 divided by P01. So if we put the given value in this equation, then here which is equal to P01, what is the value of P01, which is equal to here 17 mm of Hg, minus P1 divided by 17, which is equal to, what is the value of W2, which is equal to 2.8 into M1 means the molar mass of the solvent. Here M1 means the molar mass of the solvent, and in this given, here we have given a water as a solvent, then what is the value of M1, which is equal to 18 gram. What is the molar mass of the water? It is equal to molar mass or the molecular weight, 18 gram. And M2, what is the molar mass of the urea? The urea, they are having a molar mass which is equal to 60 gram. What is the structure of urea? NH2C double bond O and H2. And from this formula of urea, we have to calculate the molar mass of the urea, and it is equal to 60 gram. So put this value, what is M1, which is equal to here 18, and therefore it is equal to 18 divided by M2. M2 means 16 into W1. What is the value of W1? It is equal to 50 gram. Therefore, if we simplify this, that means from, by using the log table, you have to take in the log of 2.8 plus log of 18, then again log of 60 plus log of 50, and then we have to minus the log of this into this, then we get some value here. And therefore here, if we have 17 minus P1, which is equal to 2.8 into 18 divided by 60 into 15 into here 17. हे जर आपण इकडे घेतलं तर याला काय होणार आहे, ते मल्टीप्लाय होणार आहे, आणि जर आपण याची व्हॅल्यू काढली, या पूर्ण इक्वेशनची जर ती व्हॅल्यू काढली, तुम्ही ते लॉग टेबल वापरून ती व्हॅल्यू तुम्ही काढणार आहात, आणि जर ती तुम्ही व्हॅल्यू काढली तर तुमची किती येणार आहे व्हॅल्यू, सगळ्यांनी तो ट्राय करायचा आहे, लॉग टेबल वापरायचे सगळ्यांनी, आणि लॉग टेबल वापरून ते सोडवायचे सगळ्यांनी. ठीक आहे, द व्हॅल्यू for this example is here, wait a minute, the value of this multiplication, which is equal to 0.2856, which is equal to 0.2856, which is equal to 17 minus P, and therefore P1, which is equal to 17 minus this value, that means here we have an answer which is equal to 16.714 mm of Hg, that is the P1. P1 means, what is the P1? P1 means the vapor pressure of a solution. Here we have a vapor pressure of a solution. So we have to solve this example by using the formula relative lowering of vapor pressure, which is equal to W2 M1 M2 W1, and therefore here this is our given data, and from that given data we have to solve the value of here P1 means what? Here
the vapor pressure of the solution. The vapor pressure of the solution having the value 16.714. This calculation is for your homework. हे जे कैलक्युलेशन आहे 2.8 × 18 × 17 या तिन्ही व्हॅल्यूचा लॉग घ्यायचा. या दोघांचा सुद्धा लॉग घेणार आहात. याच्या लॉग मधून याचा लॉग वजा करणार आहात. पहिल्यांदा ह्या यांच्या लॉगची बेरीज, या दोघांच्या लॉगची बेरीज, या लॉग मधून हा लॉग मायनस करायचा. आलेल्या उत्तराचा अँटी लॉग घ्यायचा. मग तो किती आला पाहिजे तुमचा 0.2856. ती व्हॅल्यू इथं एवढी आली पाहिजे तुमची. अँड दे आर फोर हिअर पी वन विच इज इक्वल टू, इफ यू मायनस 0.2856 × 17 मीन्स फ्रॉम द 17, बिकॉज पी वन विच इज इक्वल टू हिअर 17 मायनस दिस व्हॅल्यू, अँड दे आर फोर वी गेट द फायनल आन्सर ॲज हिअर 16.714. सो डिअर स्टुडंट, दिस इज वन ऑफ द एक्झाम्पल फ्रॉम युअर टेक्स्ट बुक, 9 नंबर एक्झाम्पल. यू हॅव टू सॉल्व ऑल द एक्झाम्पल केअरफुली. इफ यू हॅव एनी डाऊट देन वी विल डिस्कस इट इन अवर मीट. ओके, सो डिअर स्टुडंट, हियर वी हॅव कम्प्लीटेड अवर टॉपिक विथ दिस वन एक्झाम्पल. यू हॅव टू सॉल्व ऑल द एक्सरसाइज्ड एक्झाम्पल इन युअर नोटबुक. So dear student, here in this today's lecture we will stop here, and we will meet in the next lecture with the new topic. Till then, thank you.